I was young, but now I'm old. I have seen everything change except this. My name is Gregory Okello, and welcome to my new podcast, where we will analyze every detail and news story that you should be aware about, but it is never on the news. We will tell you everything you never thought was important, including how was milk discovered? I mean, what was that human being even doing with the cow? But trust me, he wasn't even doing what you are thinking. The guy back from 13 AD, by the name...
Hey, that's not for today.
Excuse me?
That's not for today.
Not today? Okay. Trust me, we will reserve that for its own episode. But I swear, if you wanna know how milk was discovered, please, so that you don't miss the milky episode when my producers finally let me air it, shall we hit the subscribe button so we can get going. Today we focus on business, why you should be open about your prices, and why Jeff Bezos will be the first trillionaire to ever live. Now, do you remember that day you saw those sunglasses, a car, or even outfits online, and immediately you wanted to get it, but you did not because the products were hidden? Here is how it works. You see these products on Instagram, no price. It gives you a link to the website, you click the link, and the link links you to the website, which you scroll to see the price of the product, and an ad pops up asking you if you'd like to know the price of the item, of which, of course, I want to know the price of the item, and the website takes you straight to the product, but again, the product asks you to confirm that you are not a robot. How does a robot ask you to confirm that you are not a robot? This is like a human resource manager asking an employee to confirm that he's an employee. But again, after you confirm that you are not a robot, the website asks you to call or text this number so that you can speak to a live agent. It is at this point that you realize you have just wasted 20 minutes of your time. You are angrier than you were before you saw the products, all because you wanted to see the price.
Okay. Okay. Disappointed! Son of a bitch! What do you have to do in this life to make people trust you?
Shut up!
I have never seen a company that is doing so well yet they hide their prices. The biggest company today, Amazon. Of course, from the news, we all know that it was started by Jeff Bezos, who is now the richest man alive. But I kid you not, there is a lot you never knew about Amazon. From the fact that this company makes about 150,000 per minute. Yes, which is basically from the time you started watching this podcast till now, they have made 1.2 million already, which is coincidentally the number of employees working there as we speak. How does this man, whose base salary is $28 an hour, change the entire retail? First and foremost, all the products sold here are never hidden, but there is a story of Jeff Bezos that you have never heard before. Having worked in Wall Street between 1986 to 1994, Mr. Bezos downed his tools and started a cross-country road trip from New York to Seattle in Washington and wrote down his business plan, which was quite simple. I'm going to sell books online. No one believed his idea. People were like, how? Where? Who? Even Jeff Bezos himself warned his first employees that there will be huge losses or the company itself would even go bankrupt.
So you're driving out here in what, 94 was it?
July of 94 is when we arrived in Seattle.
And Jeff Bezos is driving out here going, I'm gonna be a billionaire, right?
No. Jeff Bezos is driving out here having gotten his parents to invest in the company, telling them that it's very likely they'll lose their entire investment in the company. And I thought that there was a 30% chance that we might build a successful company. I never thought that we would build what Amazon.com has turned into, and I'm the most surprised person on the planet.
Yeah, this happened majorly because back then, people enjoyed running between shelves as if they were playing the Maze Runner, looking for that one book, and after they got it, then they would go to the cashier and ask for its price, crossing their fingers, hoping that they would afford it. Jeff Bezos had seen all of this hustle and struggle, but he needed money. Absolutely something you never hear often or anymore. Jeff Bezos needed money. If you hear that today, you may be astonished, probably wondering, why would he? But back then, he did. It was at this point that he got a loan worth $300,000 from his own parents because they believed in what he had. Yeah, and just like that, Amazon began. However, it's important to know that when it started, it was called Kadabra. Thank God they changed the name. Imagine receiving a parcel from Kadabra. Anyway, Mr. Bezos, despite all this, never made any profit or even did marketing for his company. All because of this.
Yeah, we have over 3,000 employees and over 4 million square feet of distribution center space. And those are things I'm very, very proud of. Because with that distribution center space and half a dozen distribution centers around the country, it allows us to get product close to customers so that we can ship it to customers in a very timely way, which improves customer service levels. That's what we're about. If there's one thing Amazon.com is about, it's obsessive attention to the customer experience end to end.
And he was known for having this obsession for customers. This is why Amazon is what it is today. All its prices are out there. Listen, if someone wants your product, they sure will get it. No wonder someone will order that camera for $200 and another guy will buy the same camera for $2,000. I believe that if something is supposed to be yours, it sure will come to you. Oh! And now that you're even talking of prizes, we can always get in touch and contribute to this page's content and provide feedback for free. Yes, for free. Finally, the reason why I say Jeff will indeed hit the $1 trillion mark is because of what happened to me over the winter. I was driving and I skid off the road and messed my car's bumper so bad that I needed a new bumper. So where best to look for a bumper if not online? So I get the exact fit for my bumper on Amazon, and they had a price range. So it was up to me to pick one according to the price range that I will prefer. I pick and proceed to the checkout before Amazon lets me know that my bumper arrives the next day and they can schedule an expert mechanic who is actually just 2 miles from my place to come fix the new bumper on my car from the comfort of my house. And I kid you not, the fixing price was even cheaper than what my mechanic quoted. How do you even say no to that deal? And then Amazon started a pharmacy. Ah, game changer. This innovation at the peak of COVID-19, which has proven to us that life can go on online, while researchers around the globe predict the downfall of retail stores in the future, it is time to get up and expose your prices and clear those unnecessary ads off your website. Before I conclude, here is a rapid fire of everything that trended in the world last week in under 1 minute. Tanzania president dies, forcing neighboring countries to go on lockdown. Asian hate gets out of control in the US. 8-year black old girl raped and face beat off in Louisville, Kentucky, and rapist pardoned by the court. Joe Biden tripped on the stairs and accused the wind for being too strong. That was our show for today. Until next week, peace.